I need your arms around me. I need to feel your touch.
Hey, what's up, guys? This is Anthony. I'm the artist of the Rona Project. Bringing you guys another video. Going to answer some questions, some new ones, and some ones that Ryan couldn't get to on the last video. Let's start with the questions. As the only person who knows the story, besides Ryan, of course, I'd have to say that the story might even be better than the art. I probably wouldn't be working on the project if it wasn't. When he came to me with it a while ago, it blew me away. So I'm pretty confident in it, and I believe you guys would like pretty much everything that's in there, because it contains a lot of things that we've always wanted to see in manga, but we never got to, and a lot of things that you're already used to seeing, and there's plenty of fight scenes, and there's, you know, a mixture of love story in there, and basically we try to incorporate every genre we could in this story, and we are giving you guys a glimpse into each character and our character descriptions and whatnot, we're hoping to give you a feel of what we're trying to portray with those characters and whatnot, and the story itself is just as detailed as everything you listen to on those character descriptions. So we've put a lot of thought into this, and Ryan's working on it every day, so you know it is that good. I believe it is that good. I'm always drawing. That's basically where I'm at, you know. Ryan being the writer, he's got a lot of, all he's got to do is write stuff, and it, you know, it's pretty quick that way, and I'm always in the back room drawing, so that's basically where I'm at, and you know, that's why you don't see me on the videos quite often. And I'm actually not even used to talking on the camera that well, so I'm sure you can tell. But yeah, that's I'm drawing most of the time. I'm pretty sure most of you've assumed that. I'm thinking that some people may think this is a one-man project because I'm not on enough. But you know, I'm working on it too. It's got to be created somehow. So I got to do the brunt work. So. This depends, you know, because unlike the big timers, you know, I don't have a crew of 5, 10, 15 people helping me doing all this stuff. It's just me, and I work 40 hours a week, so it's like, you know, there's a lot to do. So on a good day when I don't have to work, I can get 3 done on a really good day. On a normal day, you know, when I am working, probably 1, you know. I wish I had a crew of people working for me, you know. I wish I had the people doing the Photoshops and you know, all my toning and the little extra details and all that kind of stuff. But it's just one guy doing it at the moment. So it takes me a little bit longer than most people. A golden bird that flies away, a candle. This right here is my mechanical pencil. It's blue and it has blue lead in it. This is the one I use to lay out every single picture that I actually draw on the pages. This is basically my foundation. And the reason I do it with blue is because when you scan it in black and white, it doesn't show up at all. So you can mess up all you want and it won't show up. Unless if you scan it in color, of course, it's gonna show up. But black and white, blue is what you're gonna wanna use if you don't wanna have any mess ups or anything like that. So after I use this guy right here, I'll move on to this one. And this is just a regular mechanical pencil, 0.5. I use other varieties, there's 0.9 and 0.7, but I don't use those very often unless I'm doing like a very big picture. Lately, I haven't even been using this at all. I've just been going from the blue to the ink. And the ink pens I use are these Pigma Micron pens by Sakura. And let me see if you can see it, how small that is. But these are very good pens. The ink comes off really black, and it's really good. And if you use it enough, it actually, the little nib at the end kind of bends when you start drawing on a picture, and it kind of gives the same look as a quill pen would. So this is what I've been doing. So I've been going blue, then this pen right here, and then for like hair or whatnot, I will be using this brush pen made by the same company. It's a Pigma brush, and it's a smaller size. And has a brush nib on the end of that, and I'll use that for like coloring the hair or whatnot. And one of my favorite tools I use this one quite a lot, is my electric eraser. This thing is awesome right here. Every artist should get one of these. The white eraser at the end doesn't ruin the page or picture or anything like that. Every bit as useful as a kneaded eraser. So, you guys should get one of these. And also, when I do some just regular pinup art, my poster art, I'll actually go the classic manga way and use my little quill pen here. Dip it in ink and outline all the lines. I'm not that good with it yet, but it's very neat, and it gives a really authentic look to the lines that you're drawing. I don't really use this on my pages yet. I don't think I'm good enough for it, but I use this on mostly just my pinup stuff. So these are all things I use right here on a regular basis, all these guys right here. And if you're wanting to get your own, you can get every single one of these things, although I'm not sure about this one. You can get every single one of these things here at a website called dickblick.com. I had somebody ask me what my old stuff used to look like in high school, and I thought that was a really good question, so I thought I'd show you guys one of my old sketchbooks I have. Right here, I even drew on the front cover and stuff like that, and there you can see some of the pages I have in here that I've worked on. What I'll do is I'll actually see if I can scan some of these in on my computer, and I'll put it in on DeviantArt so you guys can check out my old artwork that I did. Like, I think I was probably about 15, 16 in high school. I haven't had anybody ask me about that yet. Actually, most of my old high school stuff is with my parents. They still have some of that stuff, so this is all I can offer for the moment, but I'll put some of this up so you guys can check it out. Also, you guys got to check out Nesty Santa's page. He has an art contest going on right now, and me and Ryan are a couple of the judges of the artwork there. If you want to submit, you go to his page and you can video response him and make sure to, put his contest in the title. And, there's actually prizes that'll be offered up for the first, second, and third place. And we're going to actually put a link up, I'm not sure what side, but on the side where the information is, and you guys can click on that and check his page out. Well, guys, I hope I answered some questions you guys have been wanting to know. I'm sure I didn't get to all of them, and we'll probably be doing more of these later on, because we get questions at all the times. And if we don't answer you right away, or if we don't happen to get to it, it's just because we're getting so many comments now, especially since we have so many subscribers. We're getting like quite a lot a day, and we really like to answer it all, you guys. So if we don't get to you, it's just because we're just getting overwhelmed now. Same thing goes with my DeviantArt page. I get a lot of comments there as well, so don't take it to heart, if we don't get to you. I guess I'll be heading out, so I'll see you guys later.